What's up, guys? This is Kyle from Vapor Hut, driven by you, fueled by Vapor. And today I'm going to be doing a review of Joyetech's eGrip OLED. Not bad for a little 30 watt device. Talk about a stealth vape. This is going to be kind of a cool video for me. 6 months ago, my very first video with Vapor Hut on YouTube was the eGrip, a little review and a tutorial on how to build on its RBA base. On this video, I'm also going to show you how to rebuild on that very same RBA base. So after 6 months, Joyetech releases an updated version of its original eGrip. Now when it comes to the vape experience, you're looking at just about the same device. But this added screen that they put on the new OLED version of the eGrip just makes this all around a much nicer device. It's much more convenient. Now you can see where your battery is exactly. You can see your ohms, you can see your watts, your volts. I mean, the screen feature just makes this all around a more comfortable device. You can go out with it and feel confident that, yes, my battery is high enough or full enough to last me through the night. So let's go ahead and dive into the close-up. I'll break this thing down for you and show you how to build in the RBA, just in case you missed my first video. So here's the box the eGrip OLED comes in. As you can see, it is available in different colors. We got black, silver, like the one I have, cherry red, sky blue, magic blue, I love that, and white. Inside we have the device itself. We have a user manual, a little warning card about how to fill the thing, our warranty card. Comes with a decent sized bag of O-rings, which is pretty cool. We got our wall adapter, our USB cable, and an extra atomizer. So here is the eGrip OLED. I love the little juice window feature on this device. I mean, you can clearly see how much juice is left, and it's so easy to fill it. To fill this guy, you just pop this little hatch up, stick your nozzle right in that circular hole on an angle, just fill it up, and then you're done. I mean, that puts top fill tanks to shame in terms of easeability. So on the front, we have this button that's surrounded by a 360 degree dial. And just like on the original eGrip, as we turn that dial, we're taking up the power, or the voltage in this case. But rather than having little numbers or notches all around this to kind of guesstimate what you're at in terms of your wattage, on this you have a nice screen, so you get real-time feedback on what you're at, which is just cool. And to switch between volts and watts, three clicks, now we're in wattage. We can see our battery life there, got our resistance, and if you're in wattage, it'll show volts down there, and if you're in volts, it'll show wattage down there. Comes with the same drip tip as before. It's got one big O-ring on it. It's pretty snug. It's not as snug as most dual O-ring drip tips, but it does the job. On the bottom, we have our micro USB charging port. This is where we're gonna take in and out our atomizer. And then this little hole is our airflow, if we're not using the RBA. If you're using the RBA, the hole on the bottom of it will function as the primary intake for air. But if you're not, as you can see, there's no holes on the bottom of this. This is gonna be your airflow. So that's where they distinguish between the mouth draw to lung draw. With just that little hole, it's definitely a mouth to lung hit. And this little screw right here will adjust how much airflow is coming through this hole on the bottom. You can, if you want, just take this screw all the way out, get a little bit extra airflow, but it's nothing too noticeable. So I just keep this kind of as loose as I can without it jutting out from the device. The battery in here is a 1500 mAh, and it holds 3.6 milliliters of juice. So good juice capacity. The battery is a tad small. At least now I can see where it's at. So even though it is kind of a small battery, if this is your backup, your kind of carry with you throughout the day sort of device, you should be okay. you're not sub-ohming, so you're not pulling a lot of wattage from this thing. So I'm guessing at least 6 or so hours of pretty consistent use out of this battery. Now, one cool thing about the eGrip OLED is that you don't need to use the eGrip CS heads. You can use the CL heads that Joyetech made for the Ego 1. So you have the option to use either the eGrip atomizers, the Ego 1 atomizers, or the RBA base. Just make sure if you're using the Ego 1 coils that you're using the 1 ohm coils, because this battery will not support sub-ohm vaping. So let's put this to the side, grab our RBA, and I'll show you how to do a little build for this guy. So here is the RBA base. And as you can see, there is a hole on the bottom for airflow. So that's easily doubles the amount of airflow you're getting out of the stock coils. As you guys can see, I did a build on this earlier this morning. Using 26 gauge, I did 10 wraps. Came right out to 1 ohm, which was just perfect. So let me go ahead and tear this out, clean off the RBA, and I'll show you how to do this build. For this build, I'm gonna be using 26 gauge Canthal, and I'm gonna be doing 10 wraps around a 2.4 millimeter screwdriver. And make sure you really pull the slack out of these leads, because 26 gauge can be a little bit springy. And whenever you build in the eGrip, make sure your leads go out like that, rather than coming down in the same direction, because we're gonna need one to go this way and turn in to our base, and the other one to go that way and turn in to the other side of the base. Now we're gonna go ahead and start with that back lead and have it go into the far side of the base. And once we got that pretty close, what we're gonna wanna do is just go ahead and tighten that post right there. So when you fold that coil back on top, you should have about that much room. That way it'll be just over that airflow hole when we finish building this. Go ahead and trim that extra lead so it's not in our way. Now that other lead, we're gonna wanna curve a little bit in the direction of that post hole. So I'm just gonna kinda grab it here and just give it a turn. Once we got that lead through the other side, we're gonna stick in our 2.4 millimeter bit and pull the slack from the other side of that post hole. All right, so once you've pulled the slack from that second lead and your coil looks just about in the center of your screw heads there, go ahead and tighten down this post and we'll be ready to tweak her up. Okay, once your coil looks pretty good like this, you're gonna wanna pop it in the RBA adapter. Now I'm just gonna be using this iStick 50 watt. 30 watts is a bit high, so we're gonna go down, say about 15 watts. All right. So once you have your coil glowing from the inside out, you can go ahead and let it cool off and then pop the RBA out of this RBA adapter, and then I'll show you how to wick this. Make sure you kind of spin the cotton as you pull it through the coil. This is 26 gauge, so it will pull. You can kind of hold the coil with one finger as you twist and pull. And then go ahead and just rest the side of your scissors on the edge of the RBA and snip it. Then what you want to do before you put your hood on the RBA is you want to wet this cotton. So I'm going to be using some Vapor Hut Bedrock. These are our new bottles. Don't these just look awesome? And I will be doing a video coming up of our 6 remastered flavors. So they're a little sweeter, a little more pungent. They're just even better than before. Go ahead and take a little juice. Just wet the sides of my cotton. I'll put a little bit on the coil itself. Now once you've done that, go ahead and try and slip this hood over, kind of pull it up and down. So it should look like that. I'm gonna go ahead and flip our eGrip upside down and unscrew the pre-built atomizer. And pop our RBA in. So that coil is coming in right at 1.0 ohms, exactly what we were looking for. Let's go ahead and try her out. Definitely more airy. Oh man, that Bedrock is such a delicious fruity pebbles. I know there are a lot of them out there, but Bedrock is one of the best I've ever tried. So that's the eGrip OLED. This is one small and convenient device that I definitely recommend for any new users out there. So that's the eGrip OLED by Joyetech. Honestly, this is one of the smallest, most powerful devices I've ever used. I mean, how many devices will fit in that pocket? I mean, this is just, it is a great backup. It could even be a good starter device. You have the option with the RBA, you can get into building, and if not, you have pretty nice pre-built coils. Although the pre-built coils, as I mentioned before, are more for the mouth to lung kind of hit rather than the lung hit. And even the RBA, it's kind of a stretch in my opinion to say that's for a lung hit. I mean, you can, but it's a little constricted to take it in straight to the lungs. Although it has kind of a small battery at 1500 mAh, it does hold quite a bit of juice at 3.6 milliliters, but I gotta say, the number one advantage of the eGrip series in general is the convenience factor. You're just not gonna find a device that performs this well and is this small. So I gotta give the eGrip OLED a thumbs up. Nice job, Joyetech. Well, this has been Kyle from Vapor Hut, driven by you, fueled by Vapor. Have a great day, guys.